do Excellency Mr. Chairperson, Excellency Mr. Yong Jin Kim, Assistant Director General and Regional Representative of FAO, distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I would like to express our sincere thanks to the host country, the Kingdom of Bhutan, as well as the FAO Secretariat for excellent arrangement of the virtual section of the 35th FAO Regional Conference for the Asia and the Pacific. Mr. Chairman, ladies and gentlemen, in 2020, our government is preparing a five-year social and economic development plan of the country for a period 2021 to 2025 and toward 2030. The development plan for agriculture and rural development aims to develop a smart agriculture, international integration, adaptation to climate change and pandemic diseases, including COVID-19. On behalf of Vietnam delegation, I would like to take this opportunity to propose for priority for FAO to consider in its agenda to support Vietnam and member country in coming year as follows. Firstly, FAO to continue supporting country to implement the country program framework. Focus should be on innovative way to improve engagement and benefit of smallholder farmer in agricultural value chain, improve food safety and nutrition. Equally important is strategic policy support to develop scenario of future food and agriculture transformation. Secondly, FAO as a partner to assist member country to mobilize and assess the financial resources for ending hunger and poverty and tackling the global pandemic and climate challenges. Thirdly, we would like to add our voice in recognizing the importance of addressing pandemic, disaster, and climate risk to achieve zero hunger, poverty reduction, and sustainable agriculture transformation. Let me highlight a message from FAO Regional Conference in Hanoi in 2018 that the agriculture sector is in the unique position to demonstrate coherent implementation of global frameworks, addressing common driver of vulnerability to global pandemic, climate change, disaster, and poverty. Last but not least, FAO as partner to assist member country to promote sustainable food system on health approach, climate smart agriculture or landscape approach, and strengthen the South-South cooperation issue, such as water resource management, transparency, disease, and emerging issue. Excellency, distinguished delegate, I believe that FAO more than ever need to continue its effort in reforming and renovating to further improve the effectiveness of the whole organization from FAO country regional office and headquarters. In this regard, Vietnam made an official request FAO nominate a new FAO representative to Vietnam as soon as possible. We are willing to closely work with FAO Rome in the selection process of FAO representative. In addition, we propose that FAO should create a system to assess performance of its staff so that the government can participate in this process. Thank you very much for your kind attention.